So anyway, this guy came up to me. Oh, hey, I'm from Alabama. Well, not really. I did a junior high there. Told me about his dad, and he said, I did a couple of semesters at a little junior college in Texas, and I'm out here to make it an entertainment. And I heard him later. He was pretty good. Hadn't started writing songs yet. But in the meantime, he played in Denver and played at a club there called Exodus, and I'd played there. And he comes back to California, and his manager's wife said, you know, Henry John Dietzendorf is not much of a name for an entertainer. And I like John. And she said, well, you just played in Denver, didn't you? And he said, yeah. And she said, we're going to call you John Denver. And they did. And John heard my song that I'd written about my grandmother. And I made him a little tape of it because he liked it. 8 years later, I thought he was never going to record it. He didn't even have a recording contract when he asked me for a tape of it. 8 years later, he's beginning to be a superstar, and he put my song on Back Home Again album, and it sold like 11 trillion or something like that. That was John Denver's biggest selling album. And thank God for John Denver. He had his little crash, and he's up and flying around in his little jet angel up in heaven. And I just want to say thank you, John. I'm still paying Roy. I'm still paying, you know, my bills, part of my bills every month. Royalties from this song because of him. When I was a little bitty boy, just up off of the floor, we'd go back to Grandma's house in the month in the snow. Have chicken pies, country ham, homemade butter on a grill. But the best darn thing about Grandma's house was a great big filler bed. It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft as a damn big cheek. And it was made from the feathers of 49 geese, took a whole boat of cloth for the table. In the hall, they kids some $400 a piece we'd stole from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's filler bed. After supper, we'd sit around a fire, the old folks fitting chew. Pa would talk about the farm and the war, grassy land. Watch the fire till the cobwebs fill the bowl. And the next thing I know, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the old feather bed. And it was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft as a dialect chip. And it was made from the feather of the 49 geese, took a whole bowl of cloth for the table. Holiday kids, 4 hundred dogs, and a few weeks stole from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. Sunday would come, we'd all go to church and stay for covered dish. And I'd run, play, get so tired, then I'd get my wish. To lie out flat and nap and dream with the feathers tucked under my head. But my cousins wouldn't stop tickling me on Grandma's feather bed. And it was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft as a dinette chip. And it was made from the feather of the 49 geese, took a whole bowl of cloth for the table. Kissed Aunt Lou. But if I ever had to make a choice, I guess it ought to be said. Trade them all, plus a gal down the road. Grandpa's feeling the middle. I'd trade them all, plus a gal down the road.